It's good on a hike here in Sarek National Park. Start with a boat trip across the river. We're taking today, it's a one day hike to Prinskullen, following a trail. Here used to be the trail used by the silver miners, and we're actually in a cemetery really at the moment. You see the from 1600s, this was a cemetery here, so we have to stick to the path. The kind man who sailed us over on his boat just given us instructions what to do and where to go, so we have to follow the path here and make sure we don't come off the path so we don't walk on any of the ancient graves here. So okay, let's get going. The trip is through this forest here. The only problem is completely infected with mosquitoes. They're just everywhere. We're just trying to hope we soon get out of this and up into the clearing where we get a bit of wind, and then the wind usually blows them away. It's not too much fun coming through this forest here. How other people have been? We heard they've been walking on the Kongsleden trail and talking about problems with mosquitoes. Now we know what they're talking about. So now we're walking with our waterproofs, hats on, not because it's cold, just to...
And it's not raining.
It's raining mosquitoes, that's what it's doing. Making our way through the forest here, but we haven't dared to stop hardly. Whenever we stop, we just get eaten alive. Even though we've hiked in Peru, never experienced anything like this place.
You also forgot the insect repellent. That was probably a mistake.
Yeah, never expected it to be so bad.
Oh yeah.
Okay, so we've hardly had a single break through the forest there. Just been waiting to clear the tree line here, but it's taking some time. Whew. So we're sweating here with our rainproofs on.
My hair is just like I've been in the shower, soaking wet.
Oh dear.
And the amazing thing is, I'm completely out of breath and been in all the way. And Jamie, he's not even out of breath, he's just walking like, he's walking on the flat.
It's like finished, and then like the more normal like stones and rocks, they are coming now.
You're looking forward to that and some wind. When the wind comes in, should blow away the mosquitoes. Okay, now we're starting to get somewhere. I can see the lake behind us. We'll be camping down there on that lake. About 400 meters to go. I should be on the top of Prinskullen. Sunshiny. A better change to a new dry t-shirt. Oh, nearly made it to the top. Where's the top? That's the Sarek National Park.
Reindeer poo, so that means that there are walking reindeers here, because all from when the forest was in, then we have seen lots of the poo, and now we just found out it was reindeer. So we hope that
we
see some reindeer.
Now, this is my kind of hiking, just not walking here. Great views to the Sarek National Park. Trees, so great view. We haven't seen any other people yet so far. We've got the whole mountain to ourselves. Amazing to think we'll be hiking here in the Sarek National Park above the Arctic Circle. Just imagine how cold it is here in the winter. are today on a day trip. Next time we'll bring a tent with us and we can camp full protection, ready to go back down through the forest. Oh my goodness. The forest, I've never seen so many mosquitoes.
And somebody else we just met just told to prepare ourselves for a lot of mosquitoes. So here we go.
The mosquito infested forest. Here we go. One more time. So just heading down this mountain at full speed. As fast as well as mosquitoes everywhere. As fast as we can keep walking without tripping on the branches and the roots of the trees here. And the stones. Let's just keep moving. If ever you stop here, just get eaten. Well, we just got an extra trip on this boat. This is taking us to a place where the Prinskullen trail starts for people that are. So here we're back in Kvikkjokk. So today we have a reward for the big hike through the mosquito infested forest and this nice restaurant here. Actually, where we're not far from where we're camping on the campsite. Very nice place. And Jamie's also impressed with his reindeer dinner. And that's the view. So that was the end of our 2 days here. Just 18 kilometers from the town of Kvikkjokk, which is Kvikkjokk is the town at the end of the road before you enter the Sarek National Park. So we've only been here 2 days, we've already started to feel like we know most of the locals, although there's only 16 people that live in Kvikkjokk and we've met three of them today. Two of them that was helping us with the boat. And the owners of the restaurant here, they also live in Kvikkjokk, so we're actually very friendly people. We're just tourists, but they take time to tell us about their life here, which is a special kind of life when they're living so close to the national park here, far away from everything. But, the boy in the restaurant was telling us that he hunts for his meat. He only eats reindeer and moose. So when they hunt, they kill a moose and then they have meat for 4 months. He says he eats 1.5 kilos of moose meat every day and keeps him healthy. He says he doesn't eat so many fruits or vegetables, but he likes the meat where he knows where he's where the meat's coming from. That was interesting to hear his life and here. Yeah, most of this is covered in snow, so a lot of people come here in the winter to ride around and go on snowmobile tours, snow scooter trips. So yeah, must be a cold place to be in the winter.
The real minus of this place here was the mosquitoes. As you saw today, we're battling with the mosquitoes even now. You can see them flying around here. There's no wind this evening, and that makes it worse. When the wind picks up, then the mosquitoes disappear. Today there's no wind, well, this evening, that's about 9 o'clock now. The sun doesn't go down here, we're above the Arctic Circle, so 24-hour daylight. So yeah, that's it. In the morning we'll pack away from here, move into the next national park, the Stora National Park. We'll see if we can even do a bit of biking there, not sure yet. We have to make this up as we go along. Out, being bitten on my leg now. We have to make this up as we go along, as we get here, so... didn't know too much about this place 2 days ago, now we do. Now we know some of the people, so... Okay, that's it from here. We'll pack our tent away in the morning and move on. We'll see what we discover in the next place. Okay, good night.
Good morning. Now I just walked from over there to here, and now I'm just trying to catch a fish with my fishing rod. And it's very beautiful view from here. In the background you can see the big mountains and all of the beautiful trees. And now I'm gonna fish. And just to say that I have been here on this island, I have made this little stone piece, and then the last piece go onto the stone, and then it's fished.
Make this up as we go along. Right on my hand.